The God Buckwild. How you doing, sir?
Man, I'm blessed, man. I'm just out here in the world. I just left the barbershop.
That's what's up.
I had to make sure I went early because I wanted to make sure I was right on time. And it's like, I got out like 2:55, so I was right on point.
That's what's up. Is it all appointments or is it just like lineups down the block kind of thing?
Nah, it's all appointment.
That's what's
without COVID.
That's what's up.
No.
COVID's the extra layer of everything, you know?
Yeah, it is. But it just seemed kind of funny here, you know? Where it's like everything is like you watch TV, ain't nobody got no mask on.
Yeah, that's
but
wild.
When I'm out in the street, everybody got a mask. You know?
There's agendas there, man.
Yeah, then we trying to figure out how to do it, how to do the vote thing. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to take care of that right now and get that done. Peace, man. How you?
I'm good.
All right, all right. So that's my mission right now. I'm trying to figure out how and where to get the online paperwork to get that done.
Super important. You know?
Yeah, super man, it's important for everybody. Somebody trying to hang us.
Factual.
You know, I won't, you know, I'll leave that to be a mystery. We all could figure that out.
That's what's up. So, I mean, how have you been coping with COVID-19? How did that, this hit and everybody's kind of locked in. So how did that kind of affect you and your workflow and your creativity?
I put out about 6 or 7 albums. Well, I'm on the 7th one now, something like that. So, you know, it is what it is. We got to figure out somehow, some way. We'll make it out the hood one day. You know?
that's
where we're at with this.
What can you tell me about music
and what?
Religion? Hello? Oh, we got you. I can see.
Music is my religion?
Yeah.
You got the coroner. I got shooters surrounding your cousins. It's not the Warriors. I give them chicken, make my enemies duck. Simmies tuck his tenities in the infinity truck.
To me, that was just something that I worked on with a lot of cats that I want to work with. There's no fully established artists on there. The most known artist would probably be Planet Asia.
Facts.
You know? So, but all of these guys are talented dudes I want to work with. You know, Jay Royale, Hus Kingpin, all of these cats, it's like, you know, talented fellows. I think they dope. And I think also, I'm not going to say no one's, everybody always say, hey, you know, they won't let us in. Shit, you just need an alley-oop to get in. That's all you need.
That's true.
So, yeah, so it was dope because it's like, I think we read up on the album about 5 times. So we kept selling out.
It's moving. It's moving, which is dope. There's a market for it. There's a market for the realness.
Yeah. I look at it and it's like, you know, the radio stuff is rocking on the radio now. I think what we're doing in this genre we have here, where, you know, where I'm following Flea Lord and Conway and Alchemist and, you know, Mayhem Loren and the rest of them, I think that this genre is like the missing link. What they would call hip hop. So, you know, you go from these cats and then you jump all the way to like Rick Ross and, you know, 2 Chainz, et cetera, Fat Joe. So the people who want to hear bars and beats,
yeah,
they didn't really have an outlet before. But I think since this COVID thing, like it's been a plethora of people putting albums out. So, which is a good thing, you know. People get to, you know, see what they could do. You don't have to worry about the labels trying to get a deal, trying to get signed. You know, you don't have to worry about even the features. Yo, how much money I got to pay this cat, not unless you're trying to get, you know, Griselda. And, you know, it's all love. You know, like for me, I see it as love, you know. Talking to Benny, talking to Westside, you know, I'm like, okay, cool. We'll link up one day and give the people a treat.
That'd be beautiful.
You know?
Buckwild, yeah, and Delta. Fully locked.
I'm looking at it like this, man, you know. Even though these cats who buy, and it's funny, because they'll pay a premium price for the album. But they'll get what they'll get their albums worth.
Facts.
So, which is amazing. So looking, even when I see like Al and Freddie Gibbs, you know, with what they doing, et cetera, yo, it's a lane for it. And I've seen since I started with COVID and this COVID thing, like it's been growing more and more.
Absolutely.
You know, so yeah, you know, it's fun. It's like, it reminds me of the 90s.
It's been a long time, maybe too long. Your audio produced a real rap song. I wrong a man who's counting on a jack up in the plan. Need to scan but didn't analyze the whole pro jam.
You know,
that's what I was gonna say. And that's why I think it's so cool to kind of see you embrace this, right? Because
I love it.
The music that you made is so, like, when people talk about how like Conor reminds them of the 90s, it's like your music is kind of like that's the 90s there. They're talking about. So it's so dope to see you kind of embracing this or see you have a whole album of pounds. You know what I mean?
They go back in the grow, plug through the box at me like those after the show. I drive it back, low cash for the toes. 100 an hour with a road grass in it, yo.
It kind of,
that's my God.
A whole joint even with Flea Lord.
I'm ready to do another joint with Flea Lord on the low. Mm-hmm. I think if I do this one with him, I want to drop it for New Year's.
Mm.
You know? Like I say, to me, it's fun.
Yeah.
You know? Because looking at it, like, I met Flea a year and a half ago with I met him at 38 Special Show.
Wow.
And he was like, yo, we should work. And I'm like, hell yeah. I'm a fan. And I don't think he believed it.
Fetish for the debits, your credit on edit. Haters can't come up, they never gonna get it. Only facts being spit and Brody trapped in the system. My OG rode through Queens with a Mac in his engine.
You know what I'm saying? I seen him on stage. I love his energy, you know, his performance. I love his songs. And now since knowing him, I love his hustle, how he hustles. You know, and he puts it together for the people. Whether if it's he's doing his merch, if he's putting together albums, releases, however it is, like he's one person, he's gotten busy during this time. You know, so, huh?
Absolutely. He's got like 3 or 4 joints in the last few months. Like he's.
Yeah, so did Conway.
Yeah.
You know, like I think between me, Conway, and Flea Lord, we've been consistent every month.
But it's also a testament to this. It's funny because it's kind of like Kanye West is really preaching this whole being independent and owning your own music, but it's interesting that he's not kind of including some of these artists in the conversation because, I mean, they're doing that. You know what I mean? Like, the testament, like, being able to release 3 albums just when you want is something that you can't really do in
a label. Independent.
You know what I mean?
You can't go to Universal and say, hey, I want to drop in June, July and August. They'll be like, hey, we need setup, we need this. But you know, dudes are just putting it together. Like this last album I put out, I think I had it done like 2 weeks before the release date.
Wow.
So you know, I put together a bunch of songs and it's like then I called some people and I sent out the beats and they all came back and everything just fell into place where it needed to. So looking at it, I you know, for me I believe this because I want to work with them, and they want to work with me. So, this is a great thing. You know, we don't have to worry about the label has to clear this, and we have this release that's going to interfere with this. Like I just seen, even with I think it was Willie. Like Willie just put out 2 albums, one with Alchemist, and one by himself. He got coming out, you know, October 2nd.
Just doing it. Just listen.
Yeah, but you know,
it's crazy.
You give it to the people. The people want your whole catalog. They have iPhones. They have tablets. They don't want one song. They like, yo, I only got one song. I can let me go over here. This is my new favorite artist. He's got like 10 albums.
Yeah.
You know,
right? TDE is just holding people hostage. People wait like 4 years and they get like a scissor track.
We might never hear
the whole album.
I think we're in a different time, man, and a lot of people who are signed to majors, they don't understand it. Because even some of the cats I talk to, they like, yo, you just put out an album, you gonna put out another one? And I'm like, yeah. They're like, yo, isn't it going to mess it up? No. Because now everybody who bought this album, they went back to buy the other one. And like I say, I learned this from Hank Shockley. He had a talk with us in BPM. Like, we used to hold BPM at the studio, you know, in the Digging studio. And he said, yo, you know, when it's time, like, yo, they want your whole catalog.
Absolutely.
So I'm like, wow, that's crazy. A month is up, so I'm gearing up again. You know, I love it.
To the people. You know, like, Graf was telling me that when he made Oracle 3, he was literally on stage. And somebody in the crowd was like, yo, make Oracle 3. And he was like, word? Okay. And then he went backstage and he called Green Lantern and said, yo, Green, let's do Oracle 3. And he was like, yeah. And he was like, dope. And then he went back on stage and said, I'm making Oracle 3. And then everyone else cheered. And like, it was literally that fluid. Like, imagine if there was like, you know, he had to call his manager and then they had to go to the label and they had to propose it and ask for a budget.
Yeah, that was.
Do all that rigmarole. You know what I mean?
Yeah. So you look at it, even for him and Green, they probably put it together, they put it out, and they split the bread. You know?
It's a beautiful thing. It's the way it should be.
It's a beautiful thing. Like, you know, so looking at it from that aspect, you know, I don't want to sit and give the whole thing away, but it's been a few artists, that major artists, that I told the same thing to before I got into it. Where I'm like, hey, you know, let's make the Street New York mixtape album. And they never came to fruit. But if you're established, and it's like, I look at it from this way, take like, you know, like a Jadakiss, if he, you know, they love his bars. Yeah. So if he didn't have to have hooks and stuff on there, and he could just put an album out with a producer they like, he could put like, together packages all day.
You know what I mean? You know, every major
especially right, right now.
Right now. Every major should want that ability to be like, yo, someone,
like South
I'm going to make a song. Look at Drake. Like, I mean, Drake kind of has that flexibility. Like, yo, someone dissed me. I could make a song tonight. Just put it out.
But, you know, to me,
you know what I mean?
The epitome of that, of the major artist who came and started just putting out albums whenever he wanted was Styles P.
Facts.
You know, and it's such a beautiful thing because he doesn't have anyone to tell him, like, yo, you know, you can't do this. We have to clear this artist that you got on your album. And this and this and this and that. No. Styles does the album and he puts it out.
Absolutely.
It's a beautiful thing. And that's what, you know, that's kind of what it's about. Because it's like you can cut a lot of the middle stuff out. So whatever business dealings that you have to do, you can take care of it hands on. You don't have to worry about, you know, my people are getting to your people and it take them about 6 weeks to get it together exactly. And clear whatever it is. You know? When we hear, like, yo, you know, if I'm a rapper and someone's like, yo, you know, I need you to get on my song, I'm just like, yo, send the beat over or send a song. They send the song over, then all of a sudden after they send the song, it's done in 2-3 days.
And you can just drop. You know?
Yeah.
What you want.
It's funny because even when I did the Planet Asia record, I think him and us is related. And, you know, so what I was doing after that, I was like, okay, everybody used the one verse. So I just started sending out with one verse and let people rock. And it's like, and when I had that song, I was like, yo, I think they'll compliment each other so well. So what I did was I sent it to, after Planet Asia, he sent his verse back. He sent his verse back maybe in about an hour.
Hey, yo, shots pop daily. Cops wanna jail me. And the gods rolling like the Israeli in your military, chemtrail breathing. Yo, Buck, let's deduct all the intel from all the heathens. It's Mansa Musa season.
Wow.
Which is crazy in the States.
Yeah.
You know, if you're in the majors, you're not used to that. unless you call Hov. And Hov is like, all right, cool.
For sure, yeah.
Hov is like, yo, you my man, so we ain't got to worry about the business. You know, but when you have that and it's like it comes back, people are like, the people who are competitive, because these cats, they still into rap the way we was in, you know, the 2000s.
Yeah.
So they want to get on the record and they want to wreck shit. Same thing with Ransom. Ransom is another guy. He's about to be like where Benny is right now. He's coming up on a close second or he might be neck and neck.
King with a loyal staff and a bougie queen. Come on. If you ever knew what I've truly seen, shit that's been depicted in gangster novels and movie screens, gruesome murders, don't ever speak what you heard or who you seen.
Yeah.
Because everyone's going crazy for him. So when we see these things, imagine if he was on a major, all the red tape we have to go through.
Oh, for sure. For sure.
But now, I'm pretty sure that they buzzing and they looking at him like, hey, you want to get back on the majors? We got this check with some zeros on it. We would gladly like to put your name on it. Because they have, like, the majors haven't figured it out.
Not at all.
Because no one really wants to sign a deal, especially, like, a lot of cats aren't worried about Hot 97, which is over here. Yeah. They just like, oh, you know, I could get serious. I could get the colleges. And it's like, and I'm on these playlists, and I'm rocking. And it's like, and I could be on Spotify. And it's like, I'm getting on the list on there. So they don't really care about the labels. You know, they're like, yo, why should I go through all that red tape worrying about if Flex is going to play my record?
See, the label model's not set up for the internet. It exists in a way that it insists on the fact that social media doesn't exist and you can't just connect with people like that, right? It's a world where there was long leads and, you know, I remember reading the Source magazine and, like, you cut out posters and it's, like, coming, like, 6 months from now, album, and, like real big, huge, yeah, like, long lead rollouts, and it's just not really – that's not the world anymore. People don't have 6 months. They just really don't
have time to invest. 60 grand worth of ads.
Want. They can want something, but you can't show them something and be like, this is coming out more than 5 days from now. Like, they're not going to remember it because there's so much happening concurrently. Yeah. They just can't.
People see it and they want it.
Yeah.
Because if not, they're going to see something else. That's like if I was in a studio with Conway and we did 5 songs. We could put those 5 songs out tonight. And it probably would sell better than a lot of people's albums. You know? But that's what happens when you keep building and building and building. Like, that's where, like, Flea Lord is, because he's still putting out music and he's gaining fans every day. So he's kind of following their same blueprint. You know, Conway, like I said, through this, I think he put out 3 or 4 albums. So, of course, when he drops this album, it's a huge buzz and everybody's going crazy for it.
Yeah.
And rightfully so. Like, he deserves it. He's like, he can rap. He's nice. He paid a lot of dues. Like, a lot of dudes who's rapping in this genre of music that we have, some been rapping like 10 years. Like, Pounds been rapping for 10 years plus.
Yeah.
Pounds is, and he's nice too. And like, he's put me on to some people upstate that I didn't know where. I'm like, wow, these cats is nice. All the political stuff is going out the window.
Which is dope.
You know? You make the record.
You embrace that.
Send it out to the DJs.
Embrace that, you know what I mean? Like, I love Alchemist on Griselda shit. I love Mugs on Griselda shit. I love seeing producers just kind of still be able to rock and make more money than some of the other producers trying to go through that red tape. Kind of embracing this scene at the right time. Like, I think it'll get to a point
where
no one's going to be able to afford them. Right? They're just going to be, this scene, I think, will go to a point where people will be like, yo, I need a Flea Lord verse. And he'll be like, that's, you can't afford that anymore. You know what I'm saying? But
what happened is,
kind of movement.
That's when it turns to like the major.
Exactly.
Yeah, but you got to catch it while it's hot.
Exactly.
And looking at it, so even looking at like Conway and them, like I've been going to all these shows and stuff for the past 3 years. So I've been here and it's like, I've seen him. Westside and Benny, I seen the transformation from when they first came down and they did their first show, and they were very surprised that so many established cats from New York came out and showed them love. You know, you would have Havoc, you had Prodigy, you had, you know, Raekwon, you had Styles P, you had Jadakiss, you had so many rappers, and it's like, I was there, so many cats that were established that they didn't, I guess they probably didn't know what they had. But now it's like they see, like, Westside put it together the right way. And that's all it takes is for somebody to put the biz together. Like, even though they on Shady, but they have carte blanche to put out whatever they want, whenever they want, which is amazing. That's almost like the Wu-Tang.
Mind-boggling. Deal. It's mind-boggling when you're listening to From King to a God and you hear on the first joint where he goes, and this is my first album. And you're like, wait a minute. And then you're like, holy shit, like,
that's everything only
up to this point wasn't even a real album.
But that's for the people who just getting up for him now.
Yeah.
You know? Because there's some people who never probably heard. But when it's a fire album, though, I could say that. But it's dope. I'm glad that he's having success with his album. Like, I feel he deserves it, and what he'll do is he'll kick the door in for somebody else.
Absolutely.
And like I say, for me, with my album, the one I just put out, it's kind of funny because when you look at it, as much as it grows, I don't think it's been a producer album that's probably grown as that much that fast. Which is mind-boggling to me. Cause you know, I get the Bandcamp alerts. So when I see it and I wake up and there's more than 100 alerts at one time, I'm like, wow. And then I follow on Instagram all the the radio is it goes on everybody's playlist.
Yeah.
And I see this because I'm like, yo, it's really mind-boggling because I'm like, wow, people really fuck with me. Because when you're in the majors, you can't tell who's who because you're hiding behind the artist. So right now, I'm in the front and they would be in the back, which is really dope, you know? But we all motherfucking just kumbaya. And it's like we all just in one pack together.
And that's what's dope. There is a big focus on producers, I think, more so today than there was back in the day, you know? Because one of those things where, like, even when you look at your discography, you read some songs, you're like, yo, Buck did that? Are you fucking serious? Like the Faith Evans joint, right? I love you.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Like, when I was just
some
like...
Some people don't believe I did it.
Yeah. Was like, yo, Buck did that? It's not off brand, but it was just kind of like, damn, like. So I think it's crazy
to me. What I think I had was,
what's up?
I think I was able to play in the majors and then come in the underground and play too. And everybody can't do that. Everybody can't have hit records on the radio and then come back downtown and it's like, you know, make some dope shit with some of the cast that's up and coming. But to me, I just like music. And I like the studio vibe, you know, creating records. I like, you know, having cats, you know. It's an honor for me to have the new cat in the studio. Even if it's a new cat who's on the label. Like, for me, working with Game, we cut a few records in the studio. Only one made the album. But to me, that was exciting.
Absolutely.
You know?
Absolutely. Because
when you look at it, it's like, you know, I could be like, yo, you know, yeah, you know, I did work with 50, but, you know, I think the Game record was more notoriety because it's like he was somebody who nobody heard of.
Lord, forgive me for my sins. I know it's last minute. Put the chronic in the air, a little hash in it. Spread my wings if only I could fly. Why fight to live, homie, if we living or die?
And everybody was talking about how fire his album was. And 50 already put out Get Rich or Die Trying, so he had that.
He's on.
50 album is fire.
He's on. When Massacre came, he was on. He was all
you know,
the way.
So
he was in stop. It was a no hit. It was
he
a
was
no
all the way on. Album. He sold a million the first week. Yeah. You know, so it's cool to get on 50's album, and he sell 1.1 the first week. So you're like, all right, so
just recoup
already? Nah, it's nothing wrong with it. And, you know, I kicked myself because... When he did the first album, he would always tell me, like, yo, give me some beats. Yeah, I'll save you a spot. And my mom wasn't really in it. Like, the way I'm in this, focused in this underground, like, I could go home and I could make 10 beats. And if I find the right artist to come across, you know, like, my man Rashid Chappelle.
Hi, Dr. Boy.
Peace. You know, like, Rashid Chappelle, we put a project together. And it's like I just sent them 10 beats and it was done.
Cause it's above me now, it bugs me how all these niggas love me now. And phone going dumb since Buck been down, but that's the Sean Price of fame. Rashid El Amin, that's my righteous name.
You know? And you can't do that on a major. Where it's like the artist trusts in what you're doing and what you're sending, and not saying like, yo, we need that hit record for the radio.
Yeah.
Cats are like, yo, I just need a record that I can spit something dope on or I can make a dope concept, and they off to the races. That's how it was when we was working with, like, Mike Geronimo, OC, you know, like that. On another side, you had, like, Bush Babies, you know, even when they did We Run Things. You know, you had KMD, and you know what happened from that. you know. So looking, I tell people we're in a space that we've been in before.
Yeah.
And the one thing I say is because Al was signing when he was in a group during that time, he understands how to navigate through it. Because not for nothing, he was the one who told me, like, yo, you need to leave these majors alone and come down here. So I left the majors alone and I came down here. And it's been amazing since. It's just the love that you get from everybody. 100%. No one's so political or like, oh, you working with him? I don't really like him. Everybody's cool with each other. And that's I tell you, that's the best thing. You know, you couldn't ask for a better situation. You know?
It's beautiful. And it's allowing a lot of producers to be ageless. You know what I mean? Yeah. It really is. Like I think that's the biggest, that's the kind of the coolest thing for me about Griselda is how it kind of made ageless. You know what I mean? These aren't kids that are blowing up, right? They're like in their late 30s. And they're on to this extent and being able to kind of, and no one cares. You know what I'm saying? They've shattered that age where it's like, you know, there's a time in hip hop where you hit a certain age and people are just like, oh, hey, Eddie Wall.
Yeah.
Okay.
But what,
you know what I mean?
You are 100% right, because looking at it, it would be taboo for them to be able to have a record to the South. You know, yeah. Peaking at 40. But I look at the whole situation, and I'm like, yo, at least 75% of the people are pushing that age. So when you look at it, I think it's like Ice Cube's basketball league, the Big Three.
Yeah.
So when you look at the Big Three, these are all people who were signed to labels, not labels, who were on teams, and they passed their heyday, but they still want to play.
Yeah.
So when you look, and there's some people who are playing with, like, they never had the opportunity. So when you look, especially with Conway, you know, imagine them trying to shop Conway now. Most labels would be like, how do we market him? They'd be looking at him from that point of view instead of like, yo, put the music out. He's dope. A lot of people going to like it. So they got their deal with Shady because they went first. They went into their own. And they took matters into their own hands.
Absolutely. Which is just, I love it. I love seeing it. Because it does, and to a large degree, remind me of the 90s. I love that. You know what I'm saying? Make a record, go to a place that presses up vinyls, press up those vinyls, go to stores and sell those vinyls. And just make that money. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. And it's funny because a lot of people are selling vinyl themselves.
Yeah.
So go figure. Like,
vinyl themselves.
You know, it's a whole different time, man. Huh? You say what?
Yeah, I was saying, yeah. Like, I was agreeing with you 100%. Like, there's a lot of people selling vinyl. Even, like, if you look at Bandcamp on the days when they give everybody, when they were giving artists all their money, right? Those Bandcamp days. Like, I was buying mad vinyls from up-and-coming cats. Like, everyone has vinyl. Which is, it's a beautiful thing.
But that's dope, too. And it's crazy because it's like, it pushed the majors to also press up vinyl for their artists, too. Exactly. Like, you know, I don't know how it sells, but when you look at these cats, dudes that sell, you can sell 3,000 pieces in a day. It's not a lot. It's not like you're doing 500,000 in one day. But, you know, for 3,000, that's, if you're looking at it times 30, 40, that's a pretty good income for one day. You know, just for what you're doing.
Absolutely.
You know?
I think that, see, that's the mindset. That's the mindset that a lot of kids who grew up looking at this label model don't have, right? Because the people you look up to, you know, under a label kind of guys is like Jay-Z, right? You're like, yo, he's selling billions and hundreds of thousands and millions of records, but they don't realize that you can put out a vinyl, you can sell 300 copies of it and do that a couple of times a year, and you're making $80,000, $90,000 a year. You're making a doctor's salary make with music. You can
shit. We was talking about that. Somebody asked me how much do we sell with self-titled. I don't know the numbers on the vinyl, But I know altogether we sold almost 60,000.
Double barrel from my vocal booth, I shoot with both lungs. Find me in Beirut with blowguns, I'm Babe Ruth with home runs.
Oh, yeah.
You're a crackhead with bass hits, preaching to the choir like Mace did.
And today that would be unheard of. But now I look at it from, I'm like, maybe it's not unheard of today. We just need the right marketing ploy.
Absolutely.
You know, and it's like, if we got the right music and the right marketing ploy, we could probably go through 10, 20,000 like it's nothing.
But it's also a weird time in history where if you sold 6,000 copies of something, you know what I mean? People would be like, that's a flop. Because it's not on Billboard.
Yeah.
That's not a flop. If that's, especially if you're doing it independently and that's all in your pocket, that's gorgeous.
Yeah, but for this generation, if you say I sold 6,000 pieces of vinyl, people will look at you like you're the man. You sold 6,000, son? Yeah, I need to see how you did it. You know, it's all type of ways to make money through streaming and stuff. And it's like, I just think that everyone has to look and try to learn it. You know, because everyone has an audience and people are latching on because if they didn't hear it, they want to hear it. So if they never heard my album, they want to hear it because it's something new to them. So a lot of cats that's probably never heard of me and they discovered the album and they were like, wow, yo, this is the hottest album this year. And I'm like, wow, this is crazy. You know, so I look at it, it's good to be rediscovered. It's good to be discovered. It's good for reinvention. It's good to invent. Whatever you got to do for yourself as an artist, I feel you should do. Just don't stop like, you know, like you still the guy from the 90s or the 2000s or the 2010s. You know?
Yeah.
Like I went from what was that, from March, we put out Jada's album, to putting out my own album like the next month.
Had to cover up the mouse holes, drugs in the household, sneakers too tight, you had to wear them without soles, sleeping with a sweatsuit on, cause the house cold, searching through the loaf to find the bread without mold.
It's crazy.
So to me, it's cool.
That's there's what, no need to stop. And huh? There's no need to stop and get stuck in an era, you know what I mean? That's what I think is cool about you is that you just kind of kept going. There's no reason to stop.
I love it.
To stop. There was no reason to.
I did Pounds.
Yeah.
Pounds came out in December, end of December. And it's like, it was so dope because it's like, here's a dude. And, you know, a lot of cats in the underground, they really love his album. And he's like, yo, man, that's everybody's favorite album. And they're like, wow, that's crazy. We did that.
Solid album. It's a solid album.
So it's a blessing when people like what you, I look at that as a blessing. Like, yo, you appreciate what I did. That's the ultimate blessing. Let me see if I can make some more that you'll appreciate. And that's what gave me the idea, like, even talking to Flea, like, when we spoke of working, and he's like, man, I'm putting out an album every month. I'm like, every month? He's like, yeah, man. He's like, yo, soon as if you get tired of this one, it's another one right behind it. He's like, yo, that's what they want. And then it's like, that's what took me back to Hank Shockley conversation.
Yeah.
When he was like, yo, man, you can't do that one record thing. It's like, yo, people want your whole catalog. So I was like, oh, this is what he means. You know? Because the guy who was helping me promote the album before this, he was like, yo, you know, it might be too soon for you to put out an album. So on the ninth inning, I put it out. And I told him, I said, yo, this album is doing way, like, 10 times better than the previous album with no promotion. So imagine if we had promotion. I probably would have did 10,000 CDs because we haven't dropped the vinyl yet. So I look at it and it's like, it's dope that people appreciate it. And it's dope that people are talking about it. It's dope that people are copping it. It's even more dope that people are playing it. It's dope that DJs is playing it. Like, every time I look at a list, it's like I see a record from there on the list. And I think that's incredible because that means, like, we did something that, you know, DJs appreciate and the people appreciate. And you can't buy that. So we have to keep it going.
Absolutely.
You know?
So what's next, man? What's next for Mr. Buckwild?
Oh, man. I got to write you a Christmas list for that off the record.
I'll take
it. Or maybe I'll just send you the albums as they done. You know? But you got to keep it under wraps.
Yeah, I got you.
You know? But to me, the first one that should drop, It's going to be out of two to drop. It's going to be either Rashid, Chappelle, or my man Jay. You know? Because he's got BMO on lock.
The wait is over. The A babe and A for the AV coder. What I say should be laced with bacon soda. The paper folder. Tenacious. Skating and rapes and rovers. To get that safe slip in your place like paper soldiers.
You know? And he's really dope too, man. A lot of people like him. I know I liked him when I first heard him, but it's like, I look at people and they like, yo, he's like a blast from the past. But I'm like, yo, that's what people want. They want that blast from the past. So if you like him, then that's a good thing, you know? So it'll probably be one of those. Or I have a remix album coming out from Tuff Kong. Mm-hmm. I have to send them the last two songs. Well, I got to do one more song. But I got to send them the last two remixes. So I'm just trying to figure it out, man. Long as if I can put out music and people enjoy it, that's all that counts. You know, because it's a lot of people who haven't put out music at all.
Facts.
You know? Like, I'm waiting for Diamond. Diamond put out a record putting out an album with Talib. So I want to see what this is going to sound like. Mm. You know? The only thing I can say that's dope about with this generation, when you're putting it out, like, it feels brand new. It don't sound like, oh, you know, yeah. Well, I know who this is, you know. I'm doing an album with CL Smooth. That's cool. Everybody know who CL Smooth is. Yeah. So when you get, you know, the Flea Lords and the Conways and the West Side and all that, you're getting brand new music with a brand new vibe. And that's what I like about it. That vibe will take you everywhere.
Yeah. It lets you keep growing. And it's fun. I mean, honest, it's fun to kind of not just get pigeonholed with the same artists. You know what I mean? This point in your career.
That's true, because everybody looks at it like, yo, how many times can I do an album or do records with somebody from my period that I did records with? Or why would I want to do an album all of a sudden now because it's 20 years later with somebody from my time? No. You know? We made records together. If that's the case, it's like, yo, get on the record. Like the last album, I had a little brother song. I took that and put it on there. The only guy who I work with like that, because he's my homie, is AZ. You know, and I look AA is the homie, and it's like, I'll work with him too, no matter what. But looking at it, it's like a lot of cats, you like, and Jada. Jada's definitely the homie. You look and you like, yo, you know, well, what am I getting out of this? You know? If I do this record, is it going to garner me, you know, a whole nother placement? And then it's like, one of my young homies who used to rap, he brought his artist who got signed to Mark Pitt's label. So I think he picked four beats, and we're recording three so far, so he wants more. So I'm like, yo, you know what? This is what I like, too, because I could play tennis on both sides. Because when I played him the beats, he's like, oh, man, these are incredible. And it's not the same thing I would give, you know, Flea Lord and the rest of them. So it's cool. And I love it. So I could still get a check. And then I could still get a check. Absolutely. You know? And I can...
feel good about what you're doing. Most important.
I can make something... Say what?
You can still feel good about what you're doing, too, at the same time. You know what I mean? You can make music that you love making. Not music that you have.
Yeah. You know, that... My son's 14. He like all that stuff that's out. He loves music. So for me to do it, and, you know, if I could do something that he likes, that he could take to his friends, then I feel like, yo, that would be really dope. Because even for my daughter, she's older, and she used to come with me to the studio, and she's, like, met all type of people. She used to take Source magazines to school, and that was her way of being proud or having things that she liked.
Yeah.
So if I could get it from my boy where it's like he likes it the same way, then that's cool. Because there's nothing worse than being like, hey, you know, you make music, but who you doing beats for? The internet shows you everything. You can't be, you got to be transparent. You know, you can't lie your way through that. You know? So it's pretty cool. But like I say, even with it, being able to do interviews, having talk to you guys, you know, you guys supporting, you know, the guys on the radio supporting, the guys on, you know, on Sirius supporting, man. This is, it's nothing better than this right now. If this was some major thing, it's not the same. You know?
Actual factual.
Yeah. Like, you get all type of people to come out and support. And that's a blessing for people. Like, for me to be here on the show is a blessing. Like, people don't really understand that. Like, everyone's not going to pick your music up and you're going to be this sensation. Like, you may think you're a rap sensation. No, it doesn't work that way. But if we happen to become that, then it's like, that's cool. Let's try to make it a lot bigger. That's what I'm doing with this album I'm doing now. I'm trying to make it a lot bigger. So I want to try to get some features on which will shine a light on it. You know? Because Jay is dope. And I'm like, yo, you know what, man? If we could get a couple of people, and he said it too. Yeah. So we're going to try it. You know, and it could be cats that, you know, that the underground still likes. Who might have a little juice still left. You know?
A little more left in them. A little more left in them. And there's a lot of cats like that right now. You know what I mean? Look at Method Man. You know what I mean? Look at Method Man battling and dropping. Everything he drops lately is just fire. You know what I mean?
Yeah, like him and Conway, that record is super fire. Mm. You know, and I think that's really dope. You know, now you got Meth and Red, so that means, does Meth have the fire in him? And what's Red Man doing? That's what people are probably looking at. So maybe Red Man needs to jump on something and spark it and, you know, and burn it down real quick to get that fire back inside.
We need that. It's 2020. The way this year's been, we need a Red Man and Method Man song, at least. Album would be amazing. You know what I mean?
And it don't have
still waiting on Muddy Waters too, though. I don't know. We're still waiting on Muddy Waters too. So,
yeah, he's still working on that. You know, that's Red Man. Red Man is, you know, as dope as he is lyrically, I think that he will come with it. But with Meth has been so dope. But everybody looked at him, you know, as the sex symbol, you know, on Mary album and a whole bunch of other stuff. So for him to be on Conway's joint and burn it down, I think that was dope for him and pretty incredible.
Yeah. You know?
No.
Especially, he's one of those guys where there's been, you know, I would tell kids that, yo, Method Man is so ill. Like, you just don't get it. And if they weren't there to kind of experience Tical when it was Tical, you know what I mean? I feel like it's hard to explain Method Man. The PS.
Yeah, so
I think it's dope. Like, you know what I mean?
You have to dig up, bring the pain, and be like, all right, just listen to this real quick for about an hour or two.
Your biscuits.
And then I'll send you the video, and you can watch his mannerisms, how he raps, where it's like how he lets all the words just roll off. You know what I'm saying? And I don't think even now a lot of cats really understand that.
Yeah.
Like, Method Man was the true art right there. That's why him and Reggie fit together so well.
Yeah.
They both were super animated.
Without being over animated, which is the key.
Right.
Which is the key.
Two characters. That's what I seen them as.
Yeah.
Two characters. That's why even when they made the How How movie, it was about them and it was so dope. You know, and I think for them to be able to express themselves in film, maybe some of these artists in this generation will get together and be able to do the same thing.
That'd be crazy.
Who knows?
That'd be crazy.
Yeah, it would.
In an original way. Like trying to make How High 2 is just kind of like, why?
Like, if Method Red ain't in there, then you don't need to make How High 2.
Yeah.
So I don't know why they did it.
Well, maybe it's an original, more original way, you know, and maybe like, I think what's exciting about this movement is that you have, like, you know, now you have Armani Caesar, right? You have younger artists that are kind of following and coming up in these footsteps that, you know, Griselda's just kind of like knocking down the door. So there's a whole new generation, you know what I mean? Of real rhyme spitters that are now going to kind of get a chance to actually, you know what I mean? Do something that if they were to do this, like, say, 10 years ago, people would be like, why? Why are you doing this? Nobody buys this. This isn't marketable. Stop doing this.
Yeah, but that's the powers that be to say that. That's not us. But meanwhile, if you're on Fat Beats, people will buy it and people will, you know, they'll buy it and they'll play it. But we stopped doing what we wanted to when we start listening to the majors. Mm. When we had Fat Beats and Carolines and all of that, we were doing well with what we had. Yeah. You know, when we listened to the guy who was up at Universal, it was like, yo, nobody wants to hear this. Now, this is what people want to hear. Then, you know, he played something that Genius was talking about on a Wu-Tang record. And then he's like, you know, so who puts you in charge of hip-hop to tell us what, you know, what we like? Yeah. You know? You don't even like hip-hop.
First of all, who's your A&R? A mountain climber who plays an electric guitar. But he don't know the meaning of dope when he's looking for a suit and tie rap that's cleaner than a bar soap.
So I think, like, this was a good time, man. I think whatever happened, somebody just knocked the building down. And we just started building it back up. And it's not just the Griseldas. It's like, it's everybody. It's you guys. It's the radio people. Everybody is building this audience. And it feels like the 90s was stretching Barbito.
It really does.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So when you look at it, like, it's going to be that. Like, even though there are way more outlets to get your music and there are way more outlets to get interviewed and to get your shine, and that's the best thing about it. Like, you don't, matter of fact, you did have a lot of outlets with, back then it was college radio, but you have to go up and down the coast to get all of these shows, but you couldn't watch it, you know?
That's true.
So I think right now, I think we good where we're at, you know? This is the best. A lot of people don't see it. Maybe it's too much for them to digest, and it's like, probably got too old where you can't, where you can't process too much. You know, but I think it's dope, you know? And not just because it's like I made a little splash, but I've been a fan of this since I seen Griselda. I was like, wow, this is hip-hop. This is what it was.
Yeah.
The next, you know, COVID comes and parks the bus in the backyard. You know what I'm saying? And we all just doing what we do.
Yeah.
You know? Amazingly having fun. Yeah. No,
I mean, it's a good situation. There's not a lot of, I mean, COVID's obviously a terrible situation. You know what I mean? We lost people and it's awful. But from a creative standpoint, there's not a lot of opportunities where people have to really just, like, do you have a job? You actually aren't allowed to go to work. Like, you have to stay home and be home. And to be able to kind of have that level of, I can just sit in my studio and cook all day. And
yeah.
It's not even like, yo, maybe I should go to the club or no, like, there is no club. There's nothing. All you have is your house right now and be creative.
All you have is your computer and beat machine and the internet.
Yeah.
And that's it. So you call your homies. And the best thing about it too, that I loved about it, everybody had like a mic set up in their crib.
Yeah.
So this is how I determine who's serious and who's not. The serious artists have a mic set up. Yeah. When you're not serious, you don't have all of that at your disposal. I was talking to Ransom. Ransom said he had his mic set up since 2000. And as times changed, he upgraded and he added on different things to it.
Of course.
You know? Incredible.
But in a world where things move like this, you know what I mean? You have to get that verse back in an hour. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's what I was saying. Like, you know, Planet H, I had that shit back like in an hour. I sent it to him about 10-something at nighttime. By midnight, that shit was in my mailbox.
Beautiful.
Yeah, and then it's like you listen to the record, people went crazy for it. And I'm like, wow. You know? But then it's like, yo, you know what? I've been with artists. Like, OC was an artist who works fast also.
Mm.
Like, it's not like, okay, I got it. He has a thought process, and it's like, to me, I think what he does, and don't quote me, I think he kind of just paints the, like, he probably just has, like, a chalkboard in his mind. And somebody wrote the whole rhyme on a chalkboard, and then he sees and visualizes it, and then, you know, his outer self takes it and puts it in the order that he wants. You know?
Crazy.
Because he's an incredible artist. And it ain't too many who can look and say that.
Yeah.
No.
Beautiful thing, bro. It's It's a beautiful
Yeah, hell yeah.
Time in the industry. It's a beautiful time in hip hop, which is something you couldn't always say. But I think the 20, you know, last few years have been beautiful in hip hop. I think for people who just listen to the radio and kind of are afraid to sort of dig a little bit, I think it's something. Uh-huh. It's absolute garbage, pure dumpster fire. But I mean, for people who kind of like to dig and look, which is, I mean, to be honest, that's kind of a trait of the 90s, right? Like, it wasn't easy to get in the 90s. You had to go buy shit. You had to dig.
But people, they're more creative now with the hip-hop aspect. Not saying, like, yo, I'm going to come in and I'm going to use this thing right here, whatever it is in your favorite keyboard or something or whatever. You know, that's all cool, too. But if you're doing this, you need the vinyl. And it's like you need the one ill part on the record and know how to flip it, let the rapper do his thing, and, you know, after the MC does his thing, then you could do what you need to do, mix it, and that's that. And that's what it's about. You know, back to just the beat and the rhyme. You know, so I'm happy with it. Like, I'm like, that's cool. When I get home, it's a couple of things I want to do. I want to get these first four songs done, you know, with my brother Jay, and so I could be on the way. You know, so that's my homework when I get home. You know, I'm not really out here like that. I'm not trying to be out here forever. It's kind of funny when you see everybody walking around like, bam, masked up.
Yeah. It's kind of it's sort of unnerving, I think, is the word. Like, mm-hmm. when I go to the store, it's funny because you wake up and you're like, yo, I'm going to go do some stuff this morning. You know, you get out, you hop in the car, and you go over to, like, Costco or whatever, you know? And then you see people lined up outside wearing masks.
Yeah.
Each other. It's like this moment where you're like, oh, yeah, shit is really not normal. It felt normal up to this point, you know?
But when I was in the barbershop, I told my barber, I said, yo, remember when I came to your crib to get a cut? And it's like everybody on TV had a mask on? I was like, yo, keep watching this, watch TV. And it's like nobody was masked up in the studios, in the television studios.
Yeah.
Go figure. You know? That's what I say. You know, maybe they listening to homie. Hey, don't wear a mask. It's not going to get you. You know, but shit, my phone's going to die too, man.
It's you all know? Good. I'm sorry. Good timing. We knocked it out. We killed it.
Yeah, I appreciate y'all, man. Anytime from whatever I got y'all need, just let me know.
Y'all
need new music, whatever. Just holler at me, and it's like, and I'll send it right through. I can send it right through the text, the email, whatever.
I love that.
All right?
God,
so just keep in touch, though.
I appreciate you, brother. I appreciate you. Much love.
Bless, man. I appreciate you guys, too. All right?
All right. Bless up.
All right. Peace.